Hello, everybody. I am the Spirit Man, the Embracer of Human Good and Annals to Fiction, and with this episode, we've got a bit of a tribute to classic cartoons as it opens up with Max and Eugene in Peril on the High Seas, which is the name of the episode, and they even have a Mickey Mouse there, too, saying Walt Disney Animation Presents. I don't know if this is supposed to be a loose representation of some classic Disney cartoon from the 30s or even the 20s, but this episode basically begins with Max and Eugene hanging out on the edge of a ship as they finally leave the island of the Leobes behind. I've already forgotten how to say their name. But, you know, they say goodbye to them, and Max and Eugene are hanging out, and they're bugging each other about following rules so much, or letting loose, so much so that Eugene accidentally knocks them both off the boat when he doesn't follow the rules of keep off the railing. They ultimately end up on a prison barge where, long story short, conveniently enough, literally pretty much every major bad guy they've taken down in the first season is on that prison barge, and they plan to sneak aboard the mainland by hijacking none other than the same boat that Rapunzel is on, the rest of the crew, their crew is on. So Eugene and Max go back and forth between following rules and letting loose in order to solve the situation. Eugene is able to leave his knife behind in a barrel that's let loose out into the water, which Rapunzel and friends eventually find when they try to look for Max and Eugene. And they realize, due to the gruel that was in the barrel and Eugene's knife being present, they realize that they must be on a prison ship nearby. So Rapunzel pretty much forces the captain to turn back and find the prison barge because the captain hates chameleons. And so Rapunzel says, we can either do this the Rapunzel way or the Pascal way. So Rapunzel, standing her ground, asserting herself once again. And meanwhile, Max and Eugene are inevitably caught by the bad guys. Well, actually, first they tie up the false Giovanni, who is a guy named Dale, apparently. And Giovanni reveals the whole big plan of them hijacking the ferry and getting to the mainland, like I said. But they forget to tie the guy up, so of course the guy gets away and warns Lady Kane about Max and Eugene being on board, because Lady Kane was such a great villain beforehand, and now she's in charge of all these people. She got out of prison somehow, and so did the Stabbington twins from the movie, who had a special appearance in the Cassandra vs. Eugene episode, which I'm pretty sure is still the only episode in this entire series that ever flat-out said that Cassandra was adopted by the Captain of the Guard, that he was not her real father, I think. We'll see how that turns out. Max and Eugene try to fight off the bad guys, but eventually Max and Eugene are both tied to an anchor and about to be forced overboard. It's kind of funny to hear the twins call Flynn Rider Eugene for a change. But just as they're about to go overboard, Rapunzel and friends arrive, and Rapunzel's wearing a pirate hat with a chameleon skull on her hat, and she yells, "Avast ye mateys!" It would have been hilarious if they played Welcome to the Jungle over that. That probably would be something to play around with. So Rapunzel fires a bunch of hot foods at the criminal ship, which is the same stuff that drove her insane in the King Pascal episode, and ultimately takes its own stab at the criminals. And Lady Kane just mocks Rapunzel, saying, "Even you can do better than that, princess." And Rapunzel says, "Oh, yes, but it's not what I'm gonna do, it's what the Firefly is gonna do." So they put out all these lights that are supposed to keep the Firefly away, and the Firefly bombards the prison barge with lots of fire. Then Rapunzel and Lady Kane have a bit of a face-off, but it's over in like 5 seconds because Rapunzel just trips Lady Kane with her hair, and that's it. Pretty anticlimactic. Then all the bad guys are beaten up and put away, including Axel. That's right, the horse Axel is back, and it's pretty cool to see Max and Axel go at it, just like the good old days. You can see Axel hates Maximus as much as Maximus hates him, and so forth, and it's really great to see. So then they reach the mainland for supplies, and all the bad guys are sent off, probably most likely back to Corona, to be thrown back in prison, while everyone gets... gather supplies, and Max and Eugene are at even ends with each other, where Max learned to let loose more, and Eugene learned to follow rules more as well. And this law book that Max had on him actually saved Eugene's life and prevented him from being stabbed in the chest. If he had been stabbed in the chest for real, you'd think, uh-oh, Rapunzel's got to heal him again, if she can even figure that out. Oh well. So the episode ends with Hookfoot leaning against the railings and falling into the ocean briefly, with Eugene saying, "Rules are made for a reason." Everybody laughs as they rescue Hookfoot, and the episode ends. So yeah, nothing too much happened here. It was a fun episode overall, seeing all the bad guys come together all at once and facing off against the heroes all at once, and, you know, I give this a solid B, like an 86%. It isn't that special. Could have been done better, and this also relates back to the problems that the first season had in regards to these villain characters not doing enough with them with their debut appearances to begin with, especially with Lady Kane, who is still by far one of the, if not the weakest villain this show has had thus far. Ugh. But oh well, it's all in good fun, and it is really good to see a Max and Eugene episode for once, which kind of brings us back to the old days of the original movie, because as Flynn as Eugene himself said, "Ah, Max, you never could get over not catching Flynn Rider. Oh, look, it's the very first wanted poster of me from when I was a teenager. Ha-ha!" Yep, well, that's all I got for this vlog. Thanks, everybody, for joining me once again. I am the Spirit Man, the Embracer of Human Good, and Analyst of Fiction, and I'll see you guys in the next Tangled Vlogs very soon. Take care, everybody. And now, a dance! Now I got my